Hello everyone, I'm James, the Chief Strategy and Sales Officer of i3D Microelectronics. I want to thank TCA for giving me the opportunity to come here and present my topic today. Just before I dive into the topic, I want to give you guys a brief introduction of what i3D Microelectronics is doing. So we're a silicon-centric microelectronic company which focuses on the end-to-end computer vision solutions. We focus on technology in three areas. First, stereoscopic. 3D sensor. Second, the sensor fusion topics being done on silicon. Third, ASIC and SoC designs. We're currently operating in three sites, US, Taiwan, and China, with 60 people in our team. And over the past 6 years, we've been accumulated over 10 MP projects across the world. With over 92 IPs we're holding, we just received our first Series A funding from Arm IoT Capital, e-tron Technology, WI Hopper Group, Sunplus, and Marubun Corporation in Japan. Today's topic, I'll be focusing a lot on the startup in relationship with semiconductor. So let me just give you a little bit of background of semiconductor overall. So in the past 2 years, right before the COVID-19, since 2018, semiconductor sales has declined actually for around 12%. And that gave it even more big negative impact for semiconductor startup to participate in the fundraising realm. Reason being that a lot of things had happened before this whole epidemic started to rise. In the past, semiconductor has been suffering from a few historical issues. First was the flop of cleantech, which seriously damaged startups' raising fund in semiconductor. Second is the rise of internet and mobile OS, attracts all the capitals greatly to the software companies rather than the semiconductor companies. Third is the rise of China. With China participating in the competition of semiconductor industry, it actually drives down the premiums, and also the competition rises with price and cost. Fourth is consolidation. In the past few years, actually a lot of listed company has been merging with each other, which gives less capitals and premiums to the startups that was developing. So what was needed to really pop the whole engine and restart again? First, we got to try to think about how to lower the cost to make a product. Second, how to expand our buyer's universe to get more people to come in and participate in the investment and also the exit. Third, more applications and more motives for our companies and VCs as well as the enterprises to come in and invest in more technologies. And that requires a lot more new technologies and new applications to be surfaced. Luckily, we have five big waves coming. First, everybody knows 5G has been a very big topic. Second are the servers and the hyperscalers. These are big computers, requires a lot of computations in a dedicated site. Third, obviously, IoT devices, which has been popping up around our world and daily lives. Fourth, the hottest topic recently, autonomous vehicle. Every one of this is driving by the essential and perhaps the most crucial wave of the five waves, artificial intelligence. So before I dive into the impact of those five waves that will bring to the semiconductor startups, let me just clarify a few things. First, AI is real. How is AI real? If you look at what's presented on the screen, you will see that there are more and more AIs being implemented specifically on this slide in the world of computer vision. More and more products are equipped with AI. And that brings the VC back. As you can see, since 2018 until 2020, there is a drastic increase in venture capital's interest in semiconductor startup, all because of AI. And why was that? Moreover, if we look at this slide over here, all the old conventional product that we're used to, such as personal computer and mobile phones, in terms of value stacking, meaning the value participation of semiconductor in each product in terms of value ratios, they're actually quite low at around 25% and 15%. But when it comes to the introduction of AI, in products such as AIoT and smart terminals, you will see that semiconductors' importance increased drastically to 50%, relatively comparison to 25% and 15%. What does AI bring overall? One of the most important things is data. Okay. Actually, 90% of the data that are around were generated in the past 2 years. 80% of those are what we call unstructured data. These are videos, voice, and things that is requires a lot of analytics. But actually, only 2% of these data are being analyzed. That will lead to an increment of semiconductor, transistor, and computation needs across the devices, whether it's from your cell phone to your wearables, smart device, to your edge server, and to data centers. And the computation intensity to calculate those data will increase. In sensors cases, the calculation transistor that need to increase to over 1 billion neurons. And then at the edge scenario and data center scenario, everything have to increase from the petaflop situation to zettaflops calculation levels. Next is the acceleration of data transfer through wire or wireless technology. Not only what we're talking about 5G, Wi-Fi 6, also the wire technology are emerging as well. USB Type-C, GMSL, and also Ethernet are also playing a vital part in our everyday life. With all those computation, with all those data, what are we gonna do with it? Actually, there are a lot more challenges that lies within the semiconductor itself. First is the memory walls. Second is the I/O. Third is the edge bottleneck. I want to pay special focus on this page here. So what does this page mean? We're getting so many sensors and so many data collection points that are collecting all the data, but actually these data cannot be moved to data centers because of the bandwidth limitation. Even with the introduction of 5G, and also Wi-Fi 6, we still see a lot of data need to be processed at the edge. Overall, that brings a huge opportunity for semiconductor startups all over these sectors. No matter you're working on projects at the data center, no matter you're working on a project at the edge, or the sensor end, or Wi-Fi, or even your wire connectivity technology, with a few very, very hot emergence of application and products, everything will come to realize in terms of bringing the new semiconductor solution technology to the surface. In the case of smart device, cars, autonomous vehicles, robots, automations, and also ADAS. The shift of computation, if we look at this page here, you will see that one of the most important things is miniaturization. If you remember back in the days, we were using all these very, very big cell phones, but they start to shrink and shrink and shrink. But as they shrink, people's demand in their functionality and their capability actually increases. A few things for, I think, a lot of semiconductor startup knows, which for any of you that are thinking about starting a semiconductor startup, these are the important factors. First is real-time process. Second, as I mentioned, miniaturization. Third, integrated functions. Fourth, autonomous, which link to the inference decisions that are being processed in the AIs. Everything in the AI realm are supposed to be automatic. Lastly, longer operating time, which means you need a better power versus performance ratio and also better batteries. Consideration for the silicon startup, moreover, in a few sectors, specifically on the AIoTs or the edge device part, you would require more end-to-end task-specific semiconductors. Secondly, you will need a lot of microverticals because there are so many complicated tasks being taken place. Each vertical will have its individual values that could survive independently or be integrated into one circuit design. Third, specific and flexibility over applications, as well as resource compunction, most importantly, cost and scalability. And just how can we find opportunities with this emergence of AI technology in the semiconductors realm? This is a very useful chart which I found in the McKinsey report. They break it down into 9 different sectors for the AI intelligence in semiconductor into layers. So if you look at first technology, there are different segments such as services, trainings, platforms, inference, and also interfaces, hardwares, which stacks in different ways. From looking at this graph, you will see the definition of each application's essence. And then from the very right, you will see the different type of technologies that are out there. If you do a cross-matching, you will see that a lot of technologies at semiconductor level are not compatible with the demand. And that actually brings the opportunities for semiconductor startups. Moreover, actually at the computational level, memory levels and storage level, and also networking are the hottest area that are being discussed. A lot of very big companies such as Google and Nvidia are taking their steps into these topics. For example, Google has been bringing up their TPU processor in the past few years, and we see the performance and also the effectiveness of such calculation units brings up the efficiency drastically. Memory, high bandwidth memory, storage, and also networking in terms of 5G and Wi-Fi 6 connectivities are all driving the semiconductor startups to move forward. The other thing we should consider is the architecture that are being shifted. In the past, 2017, you will see a lot of CPUs are being used in the realm of semiconductors. But as you can see, by the year of 2025, all of these designs will drastically transform into ASIC designs, which means more domain-specific semiconductor is needed, which means each of the devices that you own might need a different semiconductor, whereas in the past, it would be guys like Intel's or ARM Core or Qualcomm taking all the businesses across domains. So that was a middle range summary for what I've gathered for the semiconductor startup with the surge of artificial intelligence. And now I just want to go to a little bit about what we do and how we take place in this big momentum. So what we focus is on the realm of AI and also the future edge devices are the mobilitized intelligence and AIoTs, specifically on robot, UAV, UGV, and AMRs. And we're thinking about bringing the end-to-end computer vision solution on silicon to our consumers and customers. So with that, what we have to solve? The first problem are the sensors. If you see a robot, you'll quickly realize that robot not only need a lot of visions, it will need touch sensors, it will need so many different 3D sensors, 2D sensors to combine to match to human senses or even superhuman senses. But to bring those together into one silicon and to act parallel is very difficult. As a matter of fact, currently, right now, there is no suitable commercialized solution that is specifically designed for robots. Talking about it, if we break it down a little bit, we will see that actually in the case of robot and what we call the mobilitized intelligence, there are so many different things that a robot or mobilitized intelligence have to do. First is the hardware, second the OS, and we're talking about edge AI. And then cloud AI, what we should do on the cloud instead of the edge. And then lastly, the extensions. Everybody wants their robot to do more and more. Right now, what we're used to mostly right now is the cleaning robot and the robots in the factory that are doing the manufacturing for us. But everybody will want a clean robot to have a speaker and also the functions to bring you things while you're at home. So stackability becomes a very big issue, and we propose our very interesting value proposition. If I were to simplify that value, it would be silicon Legos. So what we're doing is we're stacking chips on top of chips, and that gives us flexibility over the functions and application domains. Talking about number, what does it bring to our customers? I think the most sexiest statement here will be, we can offer a product at 12 nanometer computation power with only 11% of development costs. And with that, we built our single functional unit, computational unit, on these little micro blocks that is called C blocks, on top of the P blocks, which triggers and merges all the computation instances and then parallel process it. This allows each individual C block to function its own individual task in a different ways, in the most efficient ways. To do that, we really have to thank Taiwanese government and this environment being in Taiwan. Taiwan possesses the one-stop shop quality for IC startup company. It's a very good place for us to incubate ourselves. First, we have a very complete semiconductor supply chain. We have great manufacturing, ODM, CM, to help us realize prototypes to bring our product into products. We have the fields to try out our product, and also we have a very big industry support from all over across domains. Thank you very much for your time.